9 o'clock on a Saturday. The regular crowd shuffles in. There's an old man sitting next to me, making love to his tonic and gin.
Hello everyone. I know it's been a long time, it's been about a month to be exact, since I've uploaded the second episode of the how-to series. Well, I'm here now. So, this is the third episode. Welcome back. This is going to teach you how to use both of Alex's V-triggers to their maximum potential. Honestly, I really only want to go over V-trigger 1 since V-trigger 2, in my opinion, is just hot garbage compared to the first one, you know? It's not bad. It's not bad, but compared to V-trigger 1, it's not good. But some of you may like it, so I'm not going to bash on those that do like to use it. So, you know, I will go over it and how to use it effectively as well. And, well, without further ado, let's get into V-Trigger 1. When you're using V-Trigger 1, your main goal is to get a hit on your opponent and put them into a 50-50 situation constantly, and simply make them play your game, you know? So, you must be asking yourself, well, how do I do that, Twisted, you know? Well, I'm here to teach you how. First things first, though. I don't care what rank you are. You can be bronze, silver, gold, platinum, any type. I don't care, alright? You know, if I know you still either hold parry down when you're getting pressured by a Cammy or a Rashid or a Kuma, you know? Or you may do a random sledge mid-screen, like so, you know, you're here in the neutral, maybe, you know, and then you just freeze up and you do that. Cause hey, you know, sometimes it works, right? So the parry through when they're pressing buttons on you mindlessly, that I can forgive, but you should never do a sledge, never. This right here, you should never do this, unless if it's off of a confirmed hit, like stand meaning punch, or a lariat into stand meaning punch, or something like that, you know? Every time you press heavy kick and heavy punch, every time you press these two buttons, you know, to make sledge or a parry come out, make sure that you have an intention on why you're doing it, you know? Not just, hey, you know, I did sledge mid-screen because it's been working the entire time, or hey, you know, I parried through this block string because, hey, you know, it works. No. If your opponent is good, they're going to adapt to that. And then you're them pressing buttons and then you doing the parry, they're gonna counter it somehow. They may toss in a jab here and there. You know, they might do like, I don't know, like stand medium punch and then a jab and then block. And then you're going to get screwed over. So, just, you know, always have an intention. Don't just press it because you're getting pressured and you don't know what to do. Or, you know, you want to get a free way in. If you want a free way in, just, you know, don't do that. Honestly, just EX stomp. If you're gonna stop playing the neutral, just overall, just EX stomp. I don't want to see this. If I see you doing this, I will disown you. But, yeah. Just that's what it is right now. You know, everything, just have an intention. Have an intention on why you press those buttons. That's the first things first, you know? That's what you should learn first. That's what you should get in your head first. Well, now since that's out of the way, I'm gonna show you a couple of combos that I would do in a real match that would be optimal, meaning that it gives me the best situation, and why I would go for certain V-trigger combos instead of others.
Thank you.
All right, it's over. Now I get to show you why I go for certain of these combos more often than others. You know, like maybe sometimes you see me do the same combo, the same V-trigger combo, like over and over again. And it's not because it's my preference. It's more of it's what's going to get me out of the situation that I need to get out of. For example, like if I'm in the corner, maybe I'll do like a side switch V-trigger combo. Or maybe if like I'm getting the kill, then I go for a different type of V-trigger combo. Stuff like that, little stuff like that is what really makes a big difference in your play. So pay attention to what I'm really pointing out, you know? It's what really separates an average player to a great or a pro player. So without further ado, let's get into it. The first combo that you see here is one of the more common Alex combos that most people know about. It's mainly used as his bread and butter that every Alex player pretty much should know by now. Well, I do this combo when my opponent is pretty much already in the corner. If they're not completely in the corner though, then I'll spend the meter to really push them in there. So look at the difference in range between the two when I spend the meter and when I don't. When I spend the meter, he gets closer to the corner. When I don't spend the meter, then well, I have to work a little bit harder to really push them in there. And as Alex, it's kind of hard. So it's all dependent on the situation where you have to spend the meter and when you don't, you know? This specific combo that links a heavy elbow can only work off of a standing heavy kick or standing heavy punch V-trigger cancel. Lariat's the only one that you can link heavy elbow without using V-trigger, but you have to be ready for it. So, you know, you're going to have to either be walking back, having that charge ready, or you're going to be crouching in order to really, you know, land it without moving. But that can be problematic since your opponent can think you're going for an EX like stomp or headbutt, you know? But yeah, these two combos that are up next is pretty much meant for corner carry. They're not meant for anything else except for that. You don't get anything off of them, but you do get them in the corner though, which is great. So if you're in the corner, you actually get a meaty setup. The one without using meter, you get two stand jabs and then a lariat. That'll cover both quick rise and back roll. If you're using meter, however, for EX elbow, then all you do is pretty much just dash up lariat. That's all you do. And well, yeah, that's right. That covers both wake ups. Quick rise and back roll as well. So you may be asking yourself, well, what if they don't rise at all twisted? What if they just sit there and, you know, maybe look at their phone for a little bit? Well, that's a good question. You do the same thing, except you add two extra steps. Well, two extra steps. Oh, that's right. That's right. Two steps. Two very simple steps. You want to know what you do? You add two crouching light kicks and then lariat. That's it. That's literally it. So pretty much instead of doing standing heavy punch into medium elbow and then two jabs and lariat, right? Okay, so you do that. They didn't quick rise. They didn't back roll. Oh, no. Okay. Now you just do two crouching light kicks and a lariat. Boom. Plus 10. That's it. Plus 10 setup if they get hit. Plus 6 if they block it. So you're in a very good position. Very, very good. This combo you don't really get to see too often, since you probably won't get the opportunity to land it most of the time, since you're going to be on the ground. But it's good corner carry, and it's also good to know anyways. So it can also be used as an anti-air, but you have to hit the opponent with the second hit of crouching heavy punch for it to work. If you hit him with both hits, I wouldn't attempt it. I would just go for a crouching heavy punch, V-trigger cancel, and then EX knee, if you're going to spend the V-trigger on it. Honestly, I recommend you not to do it. I recommend you to keep the V-trigger if that's the case. But it's your decisions, you know. I'm not going to tell you how to play, but I would personally not do it. Well, that's the end of the video, since I don't want to make it any longer than it already is. Well, oh, I'm sorry. Were you expecting to see V-trigger 2 tech and help with it? Well, don't expect anything. That V-trigger is useless. Just kidding. I'll upload a video on it later. I just don't want to give the, you know, I don't want to make the video longer than it already is. It's pretty damn long already. So, you know, give me around a day or two and I'll make sure those of you that use the V-Trigger get something good. Well, later boys. Thanks for watching. It means a lot to me that you're watching my content. I hope you're enjoying it. You now have my permission to leave, you know, and whack on off and go to sleep. Or, you know, maybe find a good video, find two good videos, you know, wink off to the first half. And you know, just enjoy the rest of your day and night, you know. All right, goodbye.